I do beseech you, chiefly that I might set it in my prayers. What is your name?
Miranda. Oh, my father, I have broke your hest to say so.
Good.
Admired Miranda, indeed worth what's dearest in the world. Many a lady I have eyed with best regard, and many a time hath listened to... Many a time the harmony of their tongues hath I listened to.
Hayden, you're killing me. You've had weeks to be off book.
Sorry, Mr. Keaton.
No, don't apologize to me. Apologize to your scene partner, who's been very accommodating, and to your other fellow actors, and most of all, to yourself.
Mr. Keaton, sorry to interrupt, but does this look better? I had my mom take it in a bit.
Rachel looks awesome. This is getting as surreal as last night.
Looking good, Rach.
Very cool.
Exquisite Rachel, as always.
Mr. Keaton, I'm still having trouble with... My affections are then most humble. I have no ambition to see a goodlier man. I mean, does she really mean that?
Especially because I just straight out told her I've been banging all the ladies.
Yeah, that is hard. We've talked about that line forever. We need a fresh perspective. The question is, are Miranda's feelings of instant passion for Ferdinand just inexperience in dramatic circumstances, or has she actually just met the love of her life? What do you think?
Miranda's an idiot, because falling in love is stupid. What is she, 12?
Actually, she's about 15, so your point, whoever you are, about being an idiot or being naive, is well taken.
Thanks, Mr. Keaton.
Later.
See you later, guys.
Oh, no. I have first period improv with a class full of freshmen now.
Your eye looks fabulous. Where'd you get it done?
What?
Just kidding. That asshole really clocked you.
It wasn't a big deal.
I'll just be a minute.
Okay, so why am I here again?
Oh, could you grab my belt for me? I think it's in my bag over there.
Yeah, sure.
To all of you American girls, it's sad to imagine a world without you. American girls, I'd like to be part of the world around you. Driving a car by the seaside, watching the world from the bright side. American girls in the movies, no one can tell where your heart is. American girls like dollies, with shiny smiles and plastic buddies. I wish I had.
Rachel, is this your belt?
Yes! Thank you.
I really liked your costume.
Thanks. So? Did you bring flowers for my dressing room?
I guess I owe you.
I'll hold you to that.
I'll let you finish changing now.
Chloe Price.
Rachel Amber?
Last night was amazing.
You call getting attacked by goons amazing? I've got to hang out with you more.
Deal. To tell the truth, I went to bed last night wishing it never had to end. But then I thought, why? Why does it have to end?
Is that a rhetorical question?
How would you like to join me on a little field trip?
Ditch class? You mean it?
Is that weird?
No, it's awesome.
I hoped you'd say that. Now about that eye, that is a hell of a battle scar. Do you want me to cover it up with some makeup?
Are you kidding? This is a badge of honor.
Respect. Let's get the hell out of here.
You sure you don't want to just grab the bus, or...?
Nope. If we're gonna go rogue, we're doing it right. Well?
What the hell am I getting into here?
Where does this thing go? North? Maybe we'll end up in Seattle. Pull up a chair, Price. The view's amazing.
Thing's heavier than it looks. All right, Chloe. You're on a freaking train with Rachel freaking Amber. Play it cool. Is this nervousness? Is that what this feeling is? Wish Max were here so I could ask. Should I make small talk? Is that what people do? It's nice Rachel we're having.
What?
I mean, weather. It's nice weather.
It sure is. So, it's kind of weird that we're hanging out.
You mean because I don't hang out with anyone and I don't have any friends?
You have friends.
Well, I used to. Friend. Singular. Her name is Max, but she left for greener, more northern pastures.
That sucks.
I didn't mention it earlier, but you seem to have some kind of Jedi mind powers over Mr. Keaton and the theater crew.
You mean when we were talking about true love in the play? I guess you could say I'm good with people.
Yeah. Just don't pull that stuff with me.
You will get on this train.
Oh, shit.
I bet you're wondering what we're doing.
The thought occurred, yeah.
Well... I wanted some company.
That's it?
That's it.
Try again. I'm going to need more to go on than that.
Joyrides with me aren't fun?
Joyrides to where again?
Life needs a little mystery, Chloe. Let's do something fun.
V-card's been punched, Rachel. I'm sorry.
Wow.
Too far?
Well, I don't know.
Okay, something fun. I'm all ears.
Two truths and a lie.
What?
I think we should play Two Truths and a Lie. It's a game where each person offers up three facts about themselves, two of which are the truth, and one of which is...
a lie?
Right. And then the other person has to guess which is which.
Sounds fun. You're on.
I'll start. First, I'm ambidextrous. Second, I was born in New York, the land of fashion and Broadway, to which I will one day return when my heinous exile here in Arcadia Bay comes to an end.
New York, huh? I've never been.
Not a world traveler?
Not yet, at least.
If you could travel anywhere, where would you go? Russia, Greece, Kathmandu?
Kathmandu?
One day, I'm going to climb Everest.
And I thought moving away from Arcadia Bay was ambitious. What's your third thing?
My third thing?
Two truths and a lie. You say three things.
Right. I'm a Leo. Meow.
Okay, so ambidextrous, born in New York, and a Leo. Gotcha.
So, which is the lie?
You seem more like a Cali girl to me.
Damn, Price, not bad. Long Beach, in fact. West Coast is the best coast.
I've only ever lived in Oregon, so nothing to compare it to, I guess.
Then we'll have to change that one day, won't we? Okay, your turn, Price.
First fact. Right. Something about myself. Should I start things off with a lie or with the truth? Or should I cheat? Let's see how good she really is at this game. I'm secretly the lead guitarist of an all-girl Misfits cover band called The Misfits.
Impressive.
I once broke my hand punching Stephanie Kowalski in fifth grade.
No way.
Bitch took my yoo-hoo, knocked her the fuck out.
I see you like to write notes to yourself.
Helps me stay focused.
Also, sweet scar.
I love science. Seriously, I think Neil deGrasse Tyson is the shit.
Huh. You're hella mysterious, Chloe Price.
Hella? Who says that?
It's a Cali thing. Anyway, I think I have your number. Okay. You say you love science, but you are failing chemistry.
You're saying failing chemistry means I hate science?
Or that Blackwell doesn't inspire your best work.
That place is a hellhole filled with shit, where shitty people go to be shitty to each other and themselves.
Tell me how you really feel, though. Anyway, school sucks, but you love science. I'm gonna say true. Now, about this broken hand story. It's not that I don't think you could knock Stephanie Kowalski out. A bitch takes your yoo-hoo, she's gotta get got.
Damn straight.
But you didn't get that scar from punching someone.
No.
That scar is from a distal radius fracture.
So you're a physician now?
Last summer, I performed a one-woman Doctor Who homage entitled Weeping Angel.
Wait, what?
The point is, I know that the scar you've got comes with breaking your wrist when you fall. Like, from a skateboard?
Yeah.
I guess 6 years ago?
7.
Well, shit. I always thought I was a good liar. Good thing you're pretty. So, let's talk about this lead guitarist business.
The business of show.
As much as I'd love to be a groupie to your all-girl cover band, The Misfits, I'm gonna have to call a lie on that one.
There's no way you'd ever be a groupie.
Okay, that's fair. Backup dancer.
With vocals.
Obviously. The problem is, your hand is smooth. No calluses. You don't play guitar. Pity, too. You'd look hot on stage. So, if my math is correct, you cheated. You told one truth and two lies.
Maybe I just needed to test you.
Or maybe you have trust issues.
You are crazy good at this game.
A lifetime of studying the human condition.
No, I mean you're really good at this game. It's kind of creepy.
I have a hard time imagining what creeps Chloe Price out. When your dad is the district attorney, I guess lying is something you're used to.
Seriously?
Seriously.
I know who to call if I need to get out of a ticket then. Not that I have a right of my own. Car first, embarrassing number of moving violations second.
Hey, thanks for trusting me.
Trusting you?
You played the game, I guess. You opened up a lot, that's all.
It's not a big deal.
Hate to break it to you, but Chloe Price is not exactly renowned throughout Arcadia Bay as a bastion of trust and empathy.
Trust doesn't exactly come easy to me. Maybe if you'd had my life, you'd understand.
No, I get that.
On the other hand, I got on this train with you, didn't I?
Fair point.
Wouldn't mind listening to some music.
PCH cruising, my girl she snoozing, she was all night boozing, no love hit the beam losing, I don't care who's in the car cause really we just PCH cruising, my girl snoozing, she was all night boozing, no love hit the beam losing, I don't care who's in the car cause really we just PCH
drive.
Well, bracelet. I've had it, I guess, since I was a kid in Long Beach. It reminds me that there's more to experience out there than just Arcadia Bay. Maybe one day I'll go back to Long Beach, or anywhere but here. Maybe sooner than later.
What brought that on?
Sometimes I feel like I've got no reason to stay. Don't be surprised, Chloe, if one day I'm just out of here.
Let me know if you need an accomplice.
Check it out! We're here! What? Where is here? Jump and find out! Did you say jump? No way! Scared? That's not the Chloe Price I know. Trust me, this is the only Chloe Price there.